إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم تسليمًا كثيرًا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالًا كثيرًا ونساءً واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما. أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله. Indeed the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. If somebody can get the brother a chair, jazakallah khair. فَإِنَّ أَصْدَقَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. Indeed, the most truthful of speech is the book of Allah. وَخَيْرُ الْهَدِي هَدْيُ مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And the best guidance is the guidance of our beloved messenger Muhammad صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. وَشَرُّ الْأُمُورِ مُحْدَثَاتُهَا. And the worst of affairs are those things we newly invent into this religion of ours. وَكُلَّ مُحْدَثَةٍ بِدْعَةٍ. And everything we newly invent into this religion of ours is an innovation. وَكُلَّ بِدْعَةٍ ضَلَالَةٍ. And every innovation is misguidance and it leads astray. وَكُلَّ ضَلَالَةٍ فِي النَّارِ. And every going astray, every misguidance is in the hellfire. ثُمَّ أَمَّا بَعْدُ. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, by Allah's grace and mercy, we enter another month of another Ramadan. Allah has allowed us to live to see it, to be back in this masjid, to worship Him the way He deserves to be worshipped, to fear Him the way He deserves to be feared. And without a doubt, the main reminder for this month, because it is Shahr al-Qur'an, it is the month of the Qur'an, in which it was first revealed to Prophet Muhammad ﷺ in the cave of Hira, when he was first given those words, Iqra, to read or recite. And he trembled and shaked upon hearing this, not knowing what was happening to him. And then the first five ayat of Surah Al-Aq were revealed. So let us remind ourselves with the benefit of this book, that is the actual words and speech of Allah, not a created thing as some deviants think to believe. But this is the speech of Allah that He spoke to Angel Jibreel alayhi salam to bring down to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam as the final message to all of mankind. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, شَهْرُ رَمَضَانَ الَّذِي أُنزِلَ فِيهِ الْقُرْآنِ هُدًى لِلنَّاسِ وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ. The month of Ramadan is the month in which the Qur'an was revealed. A guidance for mankind, with no other need for guidance. And clear proofs for the guidance. Clear proofs to prove to you that Allah, above the seven heavens and the throne, His arsh, above the seven heavens, above His arsh, separate from His creation, that He is the one who decreed everything. Clear proofs for His guidance and the criterion between right and wrong. ثُمَّ قَالَ اللَّهُ إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمُ وَيُبَشِّرُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ الَّذِينَ يَعْمَلُونَ الصَّالِحَاتِ أَنَّ لَهُمْ أَجْرًا كَبِيرًا. And Allah, He reveals what Allah says, what means. Verily this Qur'an, it guides to that which is most just and what is most right, and gives glad tidings to the believers, those who believe in the oneness of Allah, who firmly hold on to that tawheed and believe in His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that whoever works deeds of righteousness in addition to this, that they will have a great reward. This is a book, the speech of Allah, that has everything that we need in it. As Allah said, مَا فَرَّطْنَا فِي الْكِتَابِ مِنْ شَيْءٍ, that we have not neglected anything that you need to live a successful life, to make it to Jannah, from this book. ثُمَّ قَالُ وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ. And Allah said, what means, and we sent down this book to you as an explanation and clear proof for everything. This is a book. The words are so mighty. If someone is reciting out loud, you should lower your voice. Inshallah, barakallahu feekum. If you're praying the tahiyyat in masjid. This is a book that Allah, when He sent it down, He said, لَوْ أَنزَلْنَا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ عَلَى جَبَلٍ لَرَأَيْتُهُ خَاشِعًا مُتَصَدِّعًا مِّنْ خَشْيَةِ اللَّهِ. This was a book that if it was revealed down upon a mountain, from the fear of Allah, it would have crumbled into pieces. It would have crumbled into pieces. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, this Quran, huwa kitabullah, huwa hablullah, al-mamdud min as-sama'i ila al-ard. This is the book of Allah. It is the rope of Allah that is outstretched from the heavens to the earth. And Allah, He said, wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu, and hold tightly to the book of Allah, cling to it, firmly to it, because in it is the guidance for how you will be successful. Follow its commands to follow the Quran and obey it, and to follow the Sunnah of the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Cling firmly and tightly to it, because it is the rope of Allah, and do not become divided from this position. It doesn't mean you just go along with what everyone says if they say the Shahada and you just agree to agree. No, we go back to the Quran and the Sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. أَبْشِرُوا فَإِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ طَرَفُهُ بِيَدِ اللَّهِ وَطَرَفُهُ بِأَيْدِيكُمْ فَتَمَسَّكُوا بِهِ فَإِنَّكُمْ لَنْ تَهْلِكُوا وَلَنْ تَضِلُّوا بَعْدُهُ أَبَدًا. Hold tightly to this book and have glad tidings, because this Quran, one end of it is in the hand of Allah, the other end of it is in your hand. So what will you do with it? Cling to it, and you will never be destroyed, and you will never go astray after it. This is the message, the clear proof for our guidance, that this book that we have, that we often neglect, and we often turn the cheek from, and we often seek to not remember except in this month, this is the book that will grant us that success where both of our feet can enter into Allah's Jannah. My dear brothers in Islam, this Quran will speak on your behalf if you're a companion of it, meaning you recite it, you read it, you want to learn it, you follow it, you implement it. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم اقرأوا القرآن فإنه يأتي يوم القيامة شفيعا لأصحابه رواه مسلم. And the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, read the Quran, for verily it will come forth on the day of resurrection as an intercessor for its readers, pleading, O Allah, he tried to read me, he tried to implement me, forgive him, have mercy on him, grant him your Jannah. What better intercession that we can we have than the Quran and fasting and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because we tried to adhere to this deen as it was revealed to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم القرآن شافع متشفع القرآن شافع مشفع وما حل مصدق من جعله إمامه قاده إلى الجنة ومن جعله خلفه ساقه إلى النار. This hadith, which is authentic in the collection of a hadith from Al-Bayhaqi ibn Hibban and Al-Tabarani, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, the Quran is an intercessor. By Allah's permission, He can give it permission to intercede on our behalf on the day of resurrection. And it intercedes, and an opponent which is truthful. He who appoints this Quran as his leader or her leader, who says that I will follow my life according to what this Quran reveals, then it will lead you on a path to paradise. But he who puts it behind him, ignores it, turns blind to it, turns a deaf ear to it, then it will only lead him to the hellfire. ثم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم الصيام القرآن يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. Fasting and the Quran will come on the day of resurrection, and they will ask Allah, they will intercede on your behalf to Allah. Oh Allah, the fasting will say, and you will ask, well, how can fasting speak? This is the ilm of the ghayb, this is the knowledge of the unseen that Allah only has, but it will happen. Fasting will say, مَنَعْتُهُ الطَّعَامُ بِالنَّهَارِ. I prevented him from food and drink during the day, so let me intercede on his behalf. And the Quran will say, مَنَعْتُهُ النَّوْمُ بِاللَّيْلِ. I prohibited him, I prevented him from sleeping at night, because this is when he would recite me. So they will ask for intercession, let me intercede, and it will be granted to them. My brothers and sisters in Islam, This is the book, the words and the speech of our Creator, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from above the seven heavens, above the earth, separate from His creation, above His arsh, above His throne, that He told us would be the solution to improving our situation. There's no need for us to meet and gather and discuss what should we do to make our lives better. What should we do to improve the situation of the Muslims? What should we do this way or that way? Or what can I do to there's no need for opinion or desires or whims or thoughts or your intellect. Allah, He granted us that knowledge when He told us that in this Quran is a guidance for everyone. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم إن الله يرفع بهذا الكتاب أقواما ويدعو به آخرين رواه مسلم. And the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, Allah will raise nations by this book, those who adhere to it and follow it, and He will put down and destroy others by it. This is a book, my brothers and sisters in Islam, the words and the speech of our Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that brings you great honor, that can bring you great honor on the Day of Resurrection. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he narrates that Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, يُجِيءُ الْقُرْآنِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ فَيَقُولُ يَا رَبِّي حَلِّهِ فَيُلْبَسُ تَاجَ الْكَرَامَةِ ثُمَّ يَقُولُ يَا رَبِّي زِدْهُ فَيُلْبَسُ حُلَّةَ الْكَرَامَةِ ثُمَّ يَقُولُ يَا رَبِّي ارْضَ عَنْهُ فَيَرْضَ عَنْهُ فَيُقَالُ لَهُ اقْرَأْ وَارْقَ وَتُزَادُ بِكُلِّ آيَةٍ حَسَنَةً رواه الترمذي وهذا حديث حسن. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he told us, the one who memorized this Quran for Allah's face, not for the dunya, not to show off, not to increase in wealth by it, not to look for fame or being praised, but the one who memorized it for Allah's face, for Allah to be pleased with him, they will come on the Day of Resurrection, and the reward for reciting the Quran will say, oh Allah, decorate him and adorn him. And so he will be donned with a crown of nobility, a crown of honor. He will be given a crown to wear that the people will notice him by, that this is the one who used to recite the book of Allah. Then it will say, oh Allah, give him more than this crown. So he will be given a robe or a garment of honor, of nobility, a suit of nobility. Then it will be said, oh Lord, be pleased with him. And Allah will be pleased with him. And it will be said to this person, recite and rise up and be increased in reward for every ayah you used to recite. This is the crown, the gowns of nobility on the Day of Resurrection for those who used to recite the Book of Allah. Who does not want this honor, this nobility from your Creator who created you from nothing and brought you into existence. Then you returned into the dirt and then He brought you up again. Who does not want that honor? Honor, nobility will not come by your lineage. I don't care what family you're from. It will not come by your nationality or your country you came from. I don't care what country you're from. It will not come by how much money you have, what degrees you have on the wall, how much property you own. Your nobility, your honor will come when you are donned on the Day of Resurrection with a crown and a suit and a garment because you used to recite the Book of Allah in this dunya. Even though every desire, every whim, every shahwa is calling for you to go and fulfill your needs, fulfill your desires, fulfill your wants, fulfill your lusts, but you abandoned it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The status of the beholder of the Quran, it will be said to him, يُقَالُ لِصَاحِبِ الْقُرْآنِ, and this is an authentic hadith. The Prophet ﷺ said, it will be said to the reciter of the Quran, اقرأ وارتق ورتل كما كنت ترتل في الدنيا فإن منزلتك عند آخر آية تقرأها. This hadith, which is authentic in the Sunan of Abi Dawood and At-Tirmidhi, the Prophet ﷺ, he said, it will be said to the beholder of the Quran, recite, ascend, and ratil, read slowly and calmly. It's not about getting through the Quran. Anybody can do that. A child can do that if they know how to read, or they could say they listen to it, or whatever the matter may be. Recite slowly and distinctly as you used to in the life of this world, because your level in Jannah will be at the last ayah you recite. My brothers and sisters in Islam, knowing all of this, we know that to people we love in this life, we want to be special to them. So we may give them something. We do whatever we have to do to be special. Every child wants to be the most special to their parents. Every parent sometimes wants to be the more special of the two to their children. Everyone wants to be special to people that they consider someone that they love dearly and immensely. Well, that also stands true with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His creation. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْنِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. Allah has special people from mankind. His people. His people. Who he refers to as his special people. فَقَالُوا يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَنْ هُمْ. They asked the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who are these people who are special to Allah? How can we be of them? This was their care and their concern, always wanting to know what will please the Lord they cannot see. They worship without seeing Him. But they were always there because their belief, their iman was so strong. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ أَهْنِينَ مِنَ النَّاسِ. قَالُوا مَنْ هُمْ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ. Or يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ مَنْ هُمْ. Who are they, O Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم? He said, هُمْ أَهْلَ الْقُرْآنِ. أَهْلَ اللَّهِ وَخَاصَتَهُ. They are the people of the Qur'an. They are the special people of Allah. And they are the ones whom Allah calls His special ones. What an honor to be given that title. To be special to Allah. Called out by Allah, not for the sins, but for what you used to do of good deeds with respect to this book on the Day of Resurrection. Everyone, again, has someone special, dear to their heart. Of course, the most dearest of us should always be our parents, even above our children, above our spouses, above anybody and anything else. The parents always come there. That special feeling that we have for love for our parents, this is the love that you want Allah to have for you. So be a person of the Qur'an. Reading it, learning it, and implementing it by Allah's permission. My brothers and sisters in Islam, all of this that we know, all of this guidance, all of this pointing to how to be successful, and yet we could still fall under failing on the Day of Resurrection. Why? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, وَقَالَ الرَّسُولُ يَا رَبِّ إِنَّ قَوْمِ اتَّخَذُوا هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَهْجُورًا. Allah says what means, and the Messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he will say on the Day of Resurrection, Oh my Lord, my people deserted this Qur'an. They didn't listen to it. They didn't read it. They didn't study it. They didn't act on its laws and its commands and its orders. They had hard times. We said, أَلَا بِذِكْرُ اللَّهِ تَطْمِئِنُ الْقُلُوبِ. They had hard times, indeed with the heart, with the remembrance of Allah will the hearts find rest. But they were impatient with that. I need something that's going to help me now. So they go to haram. They lie, they cheat, they steal, they drink khamr, they drink take intoxicants, they do drugs, they gamble, they commit zina, whatever is going to fulfill them to make them feel better, even though it's a farce, it's a lie, it's an illusion, it's a delusion to them. But they do it. Allah gave us good times. Instead of praising Him and thanking Him, instead, like the Quran guided us to always turn it back, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّ إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. To Allah we belong, to Him everything will return. Everything you have is a trust. It's not yours. It does not belong to you. On paper in this dunya, it may. In the reality of the world, it belongs to Allah. Right? But when that good comes to us, you go, no, I got to this place because I worked hard. I sweat. I studied. I this, I that. I'm smart. I did this, I did that. And you attribute success to yourself. And then there are those who needed guidance and an answer, what was right, what was wrong, what they can do, what they shouldn't do. But they ignored the guidance of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to suit their own whims, their own desires, their own lusts and opinions. And this is a great crime. And many of the Muslims fall into this head first. And in addition, they shove their children into that same line of thinking instead of always going back to Allah. We do not want to fall into this position where on the Day of Resurrection it said, Oh my Lord, my people deserted this Qur'an. We ask Allah to make us from the people of the Qur'an who recite it, read it, and implement it, and make us min khasatahum, in His special people. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونصلي ونسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, all of these lessons from the Quran and from the Sunnah of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam were meant for us to choose to save ourselves. They're a guidance. The guidance for all of mankind. It's in this book. Realize whose speech this is. If you got a letter from the President of the United States or wherever else you think is important, you would be like, oh, so honored, and oh, it's on a letterhead, and you feel the embossment, and you think you're so, yeah, and what an honor to receive such a letter from a person. You have the words and the speech of the one who created everything you're seeing and looking at day in and day out, even the inside of your eyelids when you close them at night. The one who created the night and the day. The one who created the heavens and the earth. The one who created the sun and the moon. The one who created everything. He sent down these words saying, if you worship me without seeing me, I'm going to reward you. Just believe in that. And he gave us that guidance. Yet many of us, and I advise myself first, because this dunya is pulling one way, shaitan's on the end of that rope and we're going with him. And all Allah said for you to be successful, follow this book, which in it, of course, cannot be separated from it, following the sunnah of his messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I remind you and myself of the day when we are all, or we will all be buried. And the soul will be returned into the body. And our loved ones will bury us. And the dirt will fall over the grave and fill it up till it's the level of the earth again. And the companion's footsteps will be heard walking away. And two angels, blue, dark blue, severe, stern and reprimand, they will come into that grave and sit you up. If you've seen the janazah, you're like, there ain't no room to sit up. That's a different world. It's knowledge of the unseen belongs to Allah. You will sit up in that grave, even though it looks like you can barely lay down in it. You will be sit up. You will be shaken, and you will be asked some questions. Three we commonly know, and there's a fourth one that's mentioned that points back to this Quran. The first question, Man Rabbuk? It will be asked by those two angels, who is your Lord? فَيَقُولُ الْمُؤْمِنُ The believer, the Muslim, will say, رَبِّي Allah, my Lord is Allah. فَيَقُولَانْ مَا دِينُكْ The two angels will then ask, who, what is your religion? What religion do you follow? فَيَقُولُ دِينِ الْإِسْلَامِ So then, this one will say, this deceased person who is upon the truth, upon Tawheed, will say, my deen is al-Islam, my deen is al-Islam, my religion is al-Islam. And then it will be said, مَا هَذَا الرَّجُلَ الَّذِي بُعِثَ فِيكُمْ Who was this man who was sent to you, to guide you, to be an example for you? فَيَقُولُ هُوَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ He is the messenger of Allah, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then there's a fourth question that will come, فَيُقُولَانِ لَهُ وَمَا عَمِلُكُ What was your actions in your life? And many people ignore this portion of the hadith from Bara' ibn Azib. We've reviewed it before in a couple of khutab. It's a very long hadith, and we'll remind ourselves with it, inshaAllah, in the near future, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مَا عَمِلُكُ What were your actions? فَيَقُولُ قَرَأْتُ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ فَآمَنْتُ بِهِ وَصَدَّقْتُ So this person will say, the one who's successful, mind you, will say, I read the book of Allah, I believed in it, and I obeyed it. So the question that I ask myself and I ask you, if we don't read the book of Allah, if we don't follow the book of Allah, if we don't believe in the book of Allah, if we do not obey the book of Allah, how are we going to answer this question right? How are we going to answer this question right? How? There's no lying on that day. Your tongue, your arms, your legs, your feet, they're going to all speak against you. There's no lying. There's no making it up. Either you did it and you'll be able to say it, or you won't be able to. And we ask Allah to make us of those who are successful with respect to it. Amen. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, he said, just because of the time, inshaAllah, he said, indeed the home becomes spacious for its occupants. The angels will be present within it. The shayateen, the devils, will abandon it. And good in it will be increased. This is the home in which the Quran is recited. As for the home in which the Quran is not recited, it's not enough that you have 15 of them and they're up on a shelf or on the wall or in a case or in a curio cabinet or whatever it may be. This is recitation is done of it in your home. The home in which is not recited, the home will feel constricted and tight. The angels will abandon that home. The shayateen, the devils, will take a place of refuge in that home and be present within it, and the goodness in that home will decrease. The companions of our Messenger ﷺ used to give preference to the Qur'an during the month of Ramadan. Their recitation was not only to read it, but to contemplate about its verses. When Ramadan came, Sufyan al-Thawri, rahimahullah, he would leave all acts of worship, all other acts of ibadah, and focus on reading and learning and implementing the Qur'an. Malik ibn Anas, radiallahu anhuma, he used to run from all circles of knowledge of ilm during the month of Ramadan, and he turned instead to the recitation of the Qur'an. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he was asked, what is better in Qiyam? Should I read Surah Al-Baqarah and Surah Ali Imran, or should I just read Surah Al-Baqarah? Everyone would most likely say, read both of them. The more the merrier, the more the better. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, just read Surah Al-Baqarah only. Why? Because the Prophet ﷺ used to read over, when he would read over every ayah, if it mentioned tasbih, he would say subhanallah. If it mentioned hamd, he would say alhamdulillah. If it mentioned jannah, he would say Allahumma inni as'aluka al-jannah. If it mentioned the hellfire or the nar, he would say Allahumma ajinni min al-nar. So my brothers and sisters in Islam, la tihtammu fi ayna usiltum fi al-Qur'an, walakin qul ayna wasal al-Qur'an fiyya. Do not worry about necessarily where you get to in the Qur'an. Worry about where does the Qur'an reach to the depth of my heart? Or does it even enter my heart? How far does it penetrate my heart? This is what we need to question ourselves with. Because we need the guidance and it needs to be implemented. And it's all found in the Qur'an, the Book of Allah, and the Sunnah of His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, a couple of quick announcements, inshallah. We have the Qiyam here every night at 9:15. And it takes about an hour. And alhamdulillah, we invite you and your families to come, ages 10 and up for the children, no one younger. Bring your own water bottles, your own prayer mats. If you forget one, we have the sample ones here that you can then take and keep, and wear a mask. And I remind all of us at this time that the virus that we have, that we're seeing, coronavirus and COVID-19, it's mutating and it's changing. Because the sunnah prohibits me from announcing the death of someone who we cannot pray a janazah over on this minbar, there are brothers and sisters who we love, who have loved ones, who have passed away from this virus. And we ask Allah for those who have passed away to count them from the shuhada, to give them the highest of Jannah. Amen. And to make them be of those who don't have any punishment in the grave, and Allah safeguards them on the day of resurrection. Amen. We ask this sincerely. And for those who are sick with it, we ask for Allah to cure them from a cure from only that only He can provide, as He is the healer of everything. This is a serious thing. Do not be of the stupid, foolish ones who wait for something to happen to them to learn to take it seriously. Until something else comes clear, there will be rules, they have to be followed, they have to be maintained. Again, we have loved ones dear to us. Remember them in today's salah, in today's sajda, in all your ad'iyah, that Allah forgives them and has mercy upon them and grants them Jannah, and that Allah cures all the sick ones from every ailment and every illness. But remember this sincerely, because it is a struggle for many people, and many to them it's coming without any. It doesn't matter if you're young or old, healthy, sick. It comes for whomever Allah has written for it to come to. So be mindful of this. Just follow these rules and these establishments. Because I'm speaking on it, I take the mask off. If anyone has a problem with that, tell me. I'll give the khutbah with the mask on. No problem. But other than that, let's stick to these rules and safeguard it. We have other brothers and sisters coming from other masajid because they're not feeling safe the way it's being prayed in other masajid. We should make it safe so that everyone who wants to come and worship Allah feels they have that home in the month of Ramadan. If you have zakat al-mal to give, many of you like to give it in Ramadan. Zakat al-mal, this is the zakat on your wealth. It does not go to the masjid. We do not mix it to pay for anything for this masjid. It has never gone to this masjid or to the school across the street. It only goes to the poor and the needy in our community, or if we have excess outside of our community, at some times outside of the country, if we can verify that there's truly a need and that the money will be spent correctly. So we handle it very seriously, very strictly. If you have to give that, it should be in a marked envelope that says Zakat al-Mal. Okay? That way we don't mix it with any of the funds for anything that we do on a day-to-day basis. As we know, this is not permitted. It has to go to the needy, the poor, and the likes of what's revealed in Surah Tawbah. So let us be mindful again from today's khutbah to remember that we have the guidance for all of mankind. Hudan linnas wa bayyinatan min al-huda wal furqan. The clear proof for that guidance and the criterion between right and wrong. This is the speech of Allah that we recite in our prayers, the speech of Allah that we read in the from the mushaf, from our phones, wherever it may be, the actual words of our Creator. Let us honor them, and we ask Allah to give us crowns and suits of honor and nobility on the day of resurrection. Allahumma ighfir lil muslimin wal muslimat wal mu'minin wal mu'minat al ahya' minhum wal amwat innaka anta samii'un qareebun mujeeb ad da'awat ya muqallib al qulub thabbit qulubana ala deenik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit qulubana ala deenik ya muqallib al qulub thabbit qulubana ala deenik سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.